continuing with Act Two of The Apple Cart by George Bernard Shaw, we see that Van Hatten, who is the American ambassador to England, has paid the king a visit, that too unannounced, means he has not taken a prior appointment of meeting the king because he has something very important to share with him. And the important news is that America has decided to tear up the peace treaty between England and America, to forget about their Charter of Independence, and to once again rejoin the British Commonwealth. Hearing this, the king is extremely upset and shocked, and he is unable to say anything. But the queen feels it's a good thing, and she says, "We'll take it from here." The queen, looking anxiously at the king, "Don't you think so, Magnus? That is, isn't it? Above, she has just said that what a splendid thing, Mr. Van Hatten." So she wants a kind of confirmation from Magnus. So when she questions him, Magnus says, pulling himself together with a visible effort, making an effort to control himself, "May I ask, Mr. Van Hatten, with whom did this master stroke of American policy originate? In other words, who is behind this? It could not have been Bosfield, the American president's idea. Frankly, I have been accustomed to regard your president as a statesman whose mouth was the most efficient part of his head." In other words, the king believes that the American president could not have come up with this idea. Surely it was suggested to him, because the king is not so smart as to think something like this. So he says, "Frankly, I have been accustomed," means I am used to, "regard your president as a statesman," that is, as a diplomat. He spoke when he should not. He did not use his brains. He cannot have thought of this himself. Who suggested it to him? Whose idea was it? So Van Hatten says, "I must accept your criticism of Mr. Bosfield with all due reserve." The word is due, D-U-E, due reserve. "But I may mention that we Americans will probably connect the good news with the recent visit to our shores of the President of the Irish Free State." Now, the British Commonwealth was a huge empire, and it covered practically the whole world. Ireland, which is to the northeast of England, was also under British rule, but it broke away, it declared its independence like so many other colonies of England, and the independent Irish state, the president of that country had paid a visit of America. Gaelic form. Now, Gaelic is Ireland, all right? So one typist in our bureau, known to his as Mick O'Rafferty, the Irish Free State. "Jemima, we shall have the capital of Ireland, of Ireland, we can build England. In other words, we will have to shift Manhattan. In a sense, we will become the emperor and join the British Empire. We will need a grander title." Magnus is offended, naturally. "This little island? You dare call my country this little island? This little gem set in a silver sea, that is what you should say. Has it occurred to you, have you realized, Mr. Van Hatten, that rather than be reduced to a mere appendage of a big American concern, we might raise the old cry, war cry of Sinn Féin, and fight for our independence to the last drop of our blood? Okay, let's take meanings first. Magnus is not just shocked, he is very angry, he is annoyed. Alright. And appendage means extension. Extension or an extra piece that is attached to something. Okay. We might raise the old war cry of Sinn Féin. Please write the reference to Sinn Féin. Left wing. Irish. Republican political. Both in Republic of Ireland, capital R, capital I, Republic of Ireland, and it was founded in 1905 party. So he says, in a way, Magnus is out of anger. He is threatening Van Hatten that we might revive, once again raise the war cry of Sinn Féin and fight for our independence to the last drop of our blood. And why does he say this? Because America is a bigger country. It has more riches. It's a wealthier country. And even though it may rejoin the British Empire, it may try to control and be at the head of the empire. So Van Hatten says, I should be right sorry to contemplate such a reversion to a barbarous past. Now, right sorry means extremely sorry. If you do that, I would be extremely sorry to think or imagine, contemplate such a reversion, means return to a previous condition. Return to a previous condition, to a barbarous past. Barbarous means primitive or extremely brutal. Primitive or extremely brutal and uncivilized. So I would be very unhappy if something like that happens. Fortunately, it is impossible. Impossible. He is pronouncing it in an American way. The old war cry would not appeal to the cosmopolitan crews of the fleet of the League of Nations in the Atlantic. That fleet would be blockade you, sir, and I fear we should be obliged to boycott you. The $2,000,000 a year would stop. Now, in case England tries to revive or rather re-establish communist rule in the British Empire, then what may happen or what will happen? First of all, the old war cry would not appeal to the cosmopolitan crews of the fleet of the League of Nations in the Atlantic. Cosmopolitan means having people of different cultures, from all over the world. from all over the world. Crews means people who take care or look after or run a ship or a plane, a ship or an airplane. And fleet means a group of ships of the League of Nations in the Atlantic. They will not accept it. That fleet would blockade you. Blockade means surround a place by soldiers. By soldiers to stop people from reaching it. हिंदी में हम जिसको घेराबंदी कहते हैं. सो लीग ऑफ नेशंस इज प्रोटेक्टिंग द एटलांटिक ओशन बाय प्लांटिंग ships. And those very ships will surround you, आपके देश को, इंग्लैंड को, की घेराबंदी कर लेंगे. And I fear and I am afraid we shall be obliged, means forced to boycott you. Boycott you means, please write the meaning. Refuse to participate or buy stuff, STUFF, stuff from a particular company due to strong disapproval. So we Americans will be forced to boycott you. And the $2,000,000, what is this amount? This is the payment for the debt. So the $2,000,000 a year would also stop. In other words, they would no longer have any earnings from America. Remember, England had taken a loan from America. Added to that, English businessmen had invested in American industries. So even after paying the interest on the loan, the remaining money is coming back to England, which amounts to about $2,000,000,000 a year. We will not return that money anymore. So these are the threats that England may face. But the continental powers, means the other countries of Europe, do you suppose they would consent, means they would agree or accept for a moment to such a change in the balance of power? Why will the balance of power change? Because suddenly England will no longer be an individual country. It will turn into the British Empire as it used to be before. So obviously it is a question of a whole empire against individual countries. Ek taraf to samrajya ho, dusri taraf chote chote rajya ho. To kya baki ke jo countries hain Europe ki, kya wo continental powers, means the European countries, for example France and Germany and Italy and Spain, Portugal, etc. ये जो देश हैं, क्या ये हमारे को इतनी ज़्यादा सत्ता मिल जाएगी तो क्या वो इस बात को एक्सेप्ट कर लेंगे? Manhattan, why not? The change would be only nominal. Nominal means in name only. ये तो केवल कागजों में होगा, बाकी कुछ भी नहीं बदलेगा. Nominal. You call an amalgamation of the British Commonwealth with the United States a nominal change? What will France and Germany call it? Now, amalgamation means merger. To combine one or more components or companies into a new one. So the United States of America will be merging with the British Commonwealth, and you say it is a nominal change? बहुत छोटा सा बदलाव होगा. What will France and Germany call it? So Van Hatten, shaking his head indulgently, says, France and Germany? These queer old geographical expressions which you use here from old family habit do not trouble us. Queer means strange. I suppose you mean by Germany the chain of more or less Soviet republics between the Ural Mountains and the North Sea. Ye Germany ka geographical location hai. So bahut sare chote chote dweepo ka jo samuh hai usko aap Germany keh rahe hain. Well, the clever people at Moscow, us zamane mein Moscow means USSR, United States Soviet Socialist Republic, and Berlin is the capital of Germany and Moscow was the capital of USSR us zamane mein, and Geneva, are trying to federate them means unite them. किसके यूनिटी की बात हो रही है? जर्मनी के छोटे छोटे जो द्वीप हैं उनकी. एंड इट इज फुली अंडरस्टूड बिटवीन अस दैट इफ वी डू नॉट ऑब्जेक्ट टू देयर मूव दे विल नॉट ऑब्जेक्ट टू आवर्स. यानी कि दोनों साइड्स ने एक म्यूचुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग कर ली है to not interfere in each other's affairs. Agar hum English ya British Commonwealth mein judte hain, European powers koi aapatti nahi karenge. They will not raise any objections. Why? Because we will also not interfere. America will not interfere in there at unifying Germany. That is, we don't interfere in each other's affairs. About what is happening at the ends of your answer refers to the English Channel. So Americans who come there as tourists, so they bring in a lot of money for France, are full of money, and Americans are full of money. All is well in the West from the French point of view. One of the great attractions of Paris for Americans is the excursion to Old England. Excursion means is the trip that they take to Old England. From France they go to England. The French want us to feel at home here, and so do we. Why shouldn't we? After all, we are at home here because we are under British dominion. So Magnus says, in what sense, may I ask, how do you feel so comfortable being here? Well, we find here everything we are accustomed to. Accustomed to what we have used to, we are in the habit of. Our industrial products, our books, our plays, our sports, our Christian Science churches, our osteopaths, our... what he's trying to say is that England uses most of American products. Everything that you can find in the English markets has been imported from the USA, including our movies, etc. Put it in a small parcel and say our goods and our ideas. A political union with us will be just the official recognition of an already accomplished fact. Already accomplished facts means something that is already true. A union of hearts, you might call it. So the Queen intervenes. You forget, Mr. Van Hatten, we have a great national tradition. That is English. The English people are very proud of what they have. And America, that is USA by comparison, is a new country. So you are forgetting that we have something that you don't. So Van Hatten answers, the United States, ma'am, have absorbed all the great national traditions and blended them. Blended them means made them one with their own glorious tradition of freedom into something that is unique and universal. Glorious means great. Universal means something which is applicable to the whole world. So the Queen answers, we have a civilized culture which is peculiar to ourselves. Peculiar here means specific to ourselves. It may not be better than yours, but it is definitely different. That is the English culture, and the American culture is very different from each other. Well, is it? We found that culture enshrined in British material works of art, in the stately country homes of your nobility, in the cathedrals our common forefathers built as the country houses of God. And what did you do with them? You sold them to us. Now, enshrined means placed like in a temple or a church. Placed like in a temple or a church. That is, we found your culture in the British material things of art. In the stately country homes, the mansions, जिसको हम हिंदी में हवेलियाँ कहते हैं, of your nobility, the nobility is the upper class, the aristocrats, in the cathedrals our common forefathers built as the country houses of God. Cathedrals are large churches. That is, whatever you built, we found it in the market. And what did you do with them? You sold them to us. I was brought up in the shade of Ely Cathedral. Shade means in the shadow, near the Ely Cathedral, the removal of which from the county of Cambridge to New Jersey was my dear old father's first big professional job. Okay, let's take literal meanings first, then I'll explain this. County of Cambridge. Cambridge is a British town where you have the Cambridge University situated. It's a British town. And New Jersey is an American town. Okay. What Van Hatten is trying to say is that the English people have sold their buildings to the Americans. And the Americans have lifted those buildings brick by brick, carried them across the Atlantic Ocean to America and rebuilt it in on the same pattern, and they are existing there today. One example is the Ely Cathedral, which was built, which was the first major project taken up by Van Hatten's own father as his first big professional job. The building which stands on its former site is a very fine one. In my opinion, the best example of reinforced concrete of its period. But it was designed by an American architect and built by the Synthetic Building Materials Trust, an international affair. That is, when the Ely Cathedral was demolished and a new cathedral was built in its place, everything was fine. But the architect who designed it was an American, and it was built by the company which took that project was Synthetic Building Material Trust, which was an international company. People who take things as they come instead of reading books about them will be once we join up with the British Commonwealth, the English people will be very comfortable with us, because we return to them, we give them back all the old English ideas which are kept alive by the tourists who visit England. When you find some country gentleman keeping up the old English custom at Christmas and so forth, who is he? The old English custom in England, as followed in England. Who is he? He's an American who has bought the place. That is, if you find somebody continuing with the old English tradition of celebrating Christmas, who is that person doing it? He's an American who has bought the place. Your people get up the show for him because he pays for it. Get up the show means put up the show, not because it is natural to them. In other words, have sold their cultures in exchange for my. Our own best family to go from England to Ireland. Why? Because they never come back. There must be reasons why people don't come back to England. Well, can you blame them, ma'am? Look at the climate. The climate of England is really bad. It is cold and wet for most of the year. Even Ireland is more comfortable to live in. So why would they want to come back? The Queen, no, it is not the climate. It is the horse show. It is the horse show which is organized in Ireland regularly that attracts them. The King rises very thoughtfully. While the Queen and Van Hatten have been having these exchanges of dialogue, the King has been thinking. Now he stands up and Van Hatten follows his example. Magnus says, I must think over this. I have to replan all my future decisions. I have known for years past that it was on the cards. On the cards means it was expected to happen any day. When I was young and under the influence of our family tradition, which of course never recognized the rebellion of the American colonies as valid, I actually dreamed of a united English speaking empire at the head of civilization. Valid means legitimate. That is, when I was a younger person, one is more idealistic, one has dreams. So I never accepted America revolting against England. And I felt that it was not a legitimate country. That is, he's talking about America. And he dreamed of it being reunited once again with the British Commonwealth. Okay, so we'll take a break here, continue in the next session.